All right, so let's continue. As I said earlier, the we implemented Fine with some of the functionality of Fine users. Currently, we have just Fine user by username and password, right, which is going out to the database out to retrieve a user by its credential, by username and password. Let's replace now this one, Fine by username. Okay? I believe Fine by username is used by the register. Right, when you're registering, you want to see if that username is already existent. Right, so let's look at the current implementation. So let's close all. Oops, I closed all. I didn't mean to close all of them. So service model. So we need user model. We need user service. And on the client side, we probably have here in the views on the user. We have register. So register, presumably, is the one who would use this, right? If we probably didn't implement at all. Okay, let's see if we can implement that with the register. Let's see. Let's start the service. Let's start the server here, ng serve. So that's going to start the Angular environment. Okay. And let's navigate there. Okay. So I believe this is the implementation, the register. Let's make sure we are in the right place. Let's open up the HTML. Let's make sure we're in the right place. So register exclamation points. Okay, it looks like we're in the right place, right? That's the HTML side. Okay. So we're going to let's change this button to register. So if we click on that register, we would like to use this username, go out to the server and see, is that username already taken? Right? So let's implement it the way we already know how to implement it. Okay, without going to a database first. Right. So let's look at that. So how do we do this? Let's see. So we have the register, we have this placeholder username, and let's just deal with fetching the username to see if the username is already taken. We have a component for this, right? A component. This is the component that goes along with the register templates. Okay. Let me move the template. All the way to the left, and the component all the way to the left. I always like to see data flow from left to right, because so everything starts at HTML, right? And then it would go out to the component. The component, I guess, it would go out to the service, right, on the client. From the client, it would go out to the server, web service, yes? At some point, it would go out to the database, and then it would come back all the way back to the template, yes? Right. So let's start with the component. And what we would like to be able to do is, when I click on this button, I would like to try and register. Yes? So let's. There will be a click, and a click, and then we would like to try to on register. Okay? Right, which currently doesn't exist in the component. Right, so it would be somewhere here, on register. And let's make sure that indeed we are hitting this event handler. So this is register. Okay. All right. Let's try it. Let's bring up the inspect. And the console. So I click on register. Notice that it is coming up in the console. Right, so we have that button hooked up to the component. All right, the next thing would be that we want access to that username over here. All right, so since we need that, we'll need to tie this to a username attribute, and this will be some ng model that is tied to some attribute, maybe username. Okay, we don't have that on the component, so let's declare that on the component. This will be this. This will be username, which is a string. So now it's tied there. All right? Okay. Same thing with the password. There'll be an ng model tied to the password. But let's just do only those two, okay? The username and password. And again, there will be a password here, string. Everybody good? All right. So when I onRegister, what I like to be able to do is see if I have access to those values. So let's print both the username, this.username, and this.password. So let's see if I type in some bogus username and password and I register, they are undefined.
Why are they undefined? Actually, what a better thing would be to pass here username and password as arguments, and this would be username password, and this username, and this password equal password.
All right, so let's try that again. Why is it undefined? On register? I think these needs to be also like this, right? We have access to it too. Okay, there we go. All right, so we have access to it here, right? So what we'd like to be able to do is, now that we have the username and password, we'd like to be send it over to the server and say, hey, server, is this username taken already? All right. I'll probably want to do some validation, for instance, checking whether the two passwords match, right? If the two passwords don't match, don't even bother the server, right? I would highlight something on the client side if the two passwords don't match, right? Only if the passwords don't match, then I can check to see if the username is taken from the server. So let's do that. So we have the username. We would like to go out to the server to check to see for the username. For that, we need a service. And I think we already have a service for this. Let's see. We have a user service. There it is. Let's see what we have here. Apparently, we had implemented only a few API points here, right? Being able to update a user, find a user by credential, find a user by ID. We never implemented find user by username. We never implemented that. So let's do that. Let's implement it right here. So it'll say find user by username, which takes as argument username as a string. Okay. So what should this do? It should go out to the server to see if this username is taken. Right, so let's do that. It'll need a URL. And mapped to http://localhost:3100 API/user. Right? Is that the pattern we're following? Yeah. So API user and then the username. So API user, then username, equal, and then we will concatenate it with username. So this is the URL where the server is going to receive this. What doesn't it like? Oh, spaces? Okay. Oh, it's not var, sorry. It's const. All right, so now that we have it, we're gonna generate a GET request. Notice that we are handling it on the server side. We're handling right here, right? Find users, right here, right? Which is implemented right there, find users, which is listening at that URL. That URL is the URL we're trying to hit right there. Yes? And it's being handled by this function, find users, which is parsing the username and password from the query. Yes? So we have to generate a GET. That's what it says here, right? We're going to need to generate a GET at that user, at that API. Notice this slash at the beginning. Yes? /API/user, right? But notice that there's no query here. No such thing. We don't add that. Query string is ignored for the URL pattern recognizer, right? it's only parsed within the handler, the HTTP handler, that is parsing out the query parameters here. Okay? Right, and that's, and we want to come in this if statement right there. All right, we're just going to pass the username just to check to see if the user is there. All right, so we're not going to pass the password, and we're not passing the password. Right, we're only passing the username. All right, so we're going to generate a GET because that's what we want to hit. Right, it's this one, find users. It's a GET right there. So we're going to use the HTTP service. That's somewhere we have it somewhere here. There it is. This is the HTTP service. Notice that it's private HTTP. So it would be this.http.get. This is a great review for the quiz. So this.http.get, right? And we're going to pass the URL. There it is. So that's going to go out to the server, and asynchronously the server will come back to us at some point. So we're going to register for a response of type response. That is going to, we're going to return that. And we're going to unwrap that response, parse it as JSON, and just return the entire object to whoever needs it. Who needs it? The component needs it. Right? The component is the one who's going to use this service, right, to go out to the server. Right? Remember, the service layer, this client service, its only responsibility is to interact between the object world, right, and the HTTP world. The object world ends right here. We're being given a string. Okay? That's where the object world ends. Right, and then the HTTP world begins, right? And here's where the HTTP world begins, right? Trying to connect there, and then it comes back, converting everything back to objects. See that? All right. So the service layer on the client side converts between the object layer in the browser, converts it to a stream world, and then parses the stream back from HTTP and converts it back into JSON object. That's the responsibility of the service layer. The component layer up here, the register component can now use that service. We need that service. Let's see. We need to inject it here. Let's inject it. Private. This is the user service, which is of type user service. There it is. And it injected it. It imported it. Right, already. So let's need to replace that. Now that we have the user service, we can then use it right here. We can say this.userService dot the function we just created, find user by username. Right? And we're going to pass the username. There it is. Right? This is going to respond to us with a promise that we need to subscribe to. We're going to subscribe to the promise, and the promise is going to come back to us, hopefully, with a user object. And either this user object will either be empty, right, because there is no such user, or with an actual user. If it comes back with a user, it means that username is already taken. Right? We should not let them through. We should not let them go onto the profile, because that user already exists. Right? So you cannot use that. So for now, we'll just do a console log user for now. Okay? All right. So let's try it. Let's see. So that's going to hit the server right here, I hope. And it's going to hit it right there. I'm going to try and find the user by username. All right, so let's try it. So what users do we have? We have Alice. So let's try that, Alice. And Alice, and let's register. All right, so we had put a breakpoint, apparently, in the service right there. All right, it's about to generate the URL. Okay, it's about to send a GET request. All right, this is on the client side, yes, this is all on the browser side. And we're going to put a breakpoint right here when it comes back from the server. Let's go. and it failed. Let's see what it's saying. It says that the server refused connection. So apparently I never started my Node.js server. So let's start the Node.js server. That would help. So let's start the Node.js server in debug mode so that we can step through. I put a breakpoint right there. Hopefully that's where we're going to hit it. Put a breakpoint right here too. So let's try it again. Okay, again, we're on the client. You okay? All right, we hit the server. Right, the server came in here. And let's try and parse the username and password. Let's see, username. We have Alice, and the password is also, it's undefined apparently. I never passed the password. Oh yes, we only pass the username, right? Because we're verifying the username. So we're going to skip this first if statement. And we're going to check for the username. And hopefully it'll find the username. Put a breakpoint right there. Okay, it found it. And it's going to return the user. Oh, we never sent it back. We're supposed to send, oh, there it is. Response, JSON, we found the user. So let's put breakpoints right there. Continue. Okay, so we have a user. And apparently it's Alice. And notice that it's going to return it as JSON object. We're going to say OK. Continue. Notice that we're back on the server. Right? The server is receiving the response right here. On the client side, right? This is the user service. And the component is patiently waiting for this, right? Where's the component? So let's continue. If we look at the response says, status, okay, URL here. The body contains the ID, the username. So the user object is embedded instead of the body. What .json does is that it parses the body and it converts it back into JSON. Yes? Right now, it's encoded in the body as just a plain string. Right? It's going to convert that into an object. It's going to parse it. So let's continue. And hopefully in the console, it displayed it. There it is. That's the display. Everybody okay? Yes, we found it. So we can't use that username. Let's try a username that doesn't exist. Register. Again, let's continue. Goes back here. Continue. Okay, looking for the username. It's looking for it. It didn't find it, so it's going to return an empty object. And say okay. Continue. Go back to the client. Continue, and it displays in the console an empty object. Yes. So you can use logic such as if it's an empty object, then you let them through. If it's not an empty object, then it means that the user we can't let them through. Okay, make sense? All right, so on the client, we can decide to let them through if it's empty. So if a user is an empty object, then we let them through. Right, and the way we let them through is by navigating, right? And we navigate private router. We need to bring that, import Angular router, and so we can then use the router, this router that navigate, and we're going to navigate, I guess, to the profile, right? The user's profile, which I don't remember what it looks like. Let's look at how do we do it with login in the component. Oh, there it is. This is the navigation. So let's bring that in. Well, actually, if the user didn't exist, we're supposed to create the user, right? We're supposed to create the user. So actually, let's do that. Let's in the register, if we did not find it, what we should do is create the user. So let's not actually navigate. Let's not navigate. We need to create the user. So let's first move this over to the database. Let's move this over to the database before we move on to creating the user. So let's do that.